As you guys can remember, a couple of weeks ago I built my own NAS server using OnRaid. And a couple of comments asking me about building a Plex server inside of it using Docker. Well, on this video I'm going to show you the full tutorial how to install and set up Plex on your OnRaid server, and we're also going to speak about the power consumption and how many streams of videos or movies you can have at the same time with this server. First of all, I'm sorry that the video is a little bit late. I know I didn't post it last week, but I was a little bit sick and I could not make it. But anyway, first let's talk about streams. The maximal amount of streams that you can achieve with this server, it will be around 10 streams, but this while you are playing at a native resolution. If you want to do transcoding, I will not recommend to use the same build that I did. By the way guys, if you have not seen the complete build guide of the OnRaid NAS server, you can check it right here. By transcoding, I will not recommend this server because it doesn't have a GPU on it. It uses the Radeon graphics that are inside of the CPU, and the maximum amount that I can achieve is 1 or 2 transcoding to 4K, nothing more. So if you want to do transcoding, I would recommend you guys that you buy an NVIDIA graphics card, it's what works best for this. And the second thing before we start with the tutorial in how to install Plex into your OnRaid server is going to be about the power consumption of the server itself. I have everything right here. This server at idle uses only 49 watts of power. That is nothing. And when you're copying files to it, it'll achieve a maximum of 54. That is really nothing, it's really power efficient. And that is great if you want to have it on all the time and you don't want to be using so much electricity. And I also make a second power consumption test, this with all 10 streams of Plex working at that moment. The consumption was a little bit higher, well, let's say double so much, 105 watts for it. I don't know when you're going to be using more than 10 streams of Plex. Maybe in your case scenario, you're going to use it. For me, 1 or 2 is going to be most of what I really need for it. Now guys, let's jump right on the tutorial how to install Plex into OnRaid using Docker. Let's start with the tutorial. First of all, I want to say that I'm really sorry that I take so long to make this video, but I'm going to be on the channel, so don't worry about that. Let's start with this. The first thing is, you don't see this apps tab right here into your OnRaid server. You want to go into the plugins and into this tab, install plugin. And in here you want to copy and paste this address that I'm going to be putting in the description down below. You want to click on install, and when everything is installed, you're going to have the apps tab right here. But before we go into that, we're going to make a couple of shares inside of our OnRaid server to transfer the movies and files that you want to have into your Plex server. For that, just go into shares. If you want to add a share, I already have it done, but you can make it right now. You can write, for example, Plex Media. You want to type the location mode, you can leave it like this. Minimum free space, like I recommend before. Let's make it of 200 gigabytes. And you want to click on add share. Once you have your share open, go into your file browser, open your server right here, and then you can go into Plex Media and you want to create a couple of folders. I already made them, so you can have an example right here of what you can do. Movies, pictures, and videos, for example. You can close this, and now that you have all of this ready, you can start installing your Plex Media server. For that, you want to go into the apps tab, and in here you want to go into the search bar and type Plex. You're going to find a lot of repositories for it. I will recommend you to use the official Plex repository right here. So you want to click on this button and download it and install it. Once you have everything installed, you're going to see it right here into the Docker settings. And you're going to see it right here. You want to click on the icon and start your Plex Media server if you haven't already. And now that you have it already, you can click on the icon once more and go into the web UI. And in here, of course, if you don't have an account on Plex, you will have to create it. And you can go into the settings. And I'm going to show you really small and really fast how you can create and how you can add the shares and folders that we previously created into the Plex Media server. And for that, you want to go into Manage Libraries. And in here, I already have them created, but You can add one more by adding in Add Library. You can choose right here the type of library that you want to create, for example, movies, TV shows, music, and everything else. Choose, for example, other videos. Click on Next, and here is where you want to browse for the media folder. The folder, you are going to find it under Data, and in here you're going to find the folders that you created before inside of your shared of your Android server. For me, for example, it's videos. You want to select it and click Add. As simply as that. Now, all that you have to do is to add your videos and movies into that folders, and that's pretty much it. You can share it around your house, or you can even open a DNS port into your router to share it everywhere where you go. And that is pretty much it for the video, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, my friends. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. It's free and this really helps the channel out. Press the like button if you like it, dislike if you didn't like it. And like always, my friends, see you in the next time. Bye-bye. Do 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 do